Hi there, welcome to Fact Friday. I often hear that experimental design is a source of a lot of anxiety for you guys, and it makes sense, of course. Most of our experiences are applied, and experimental design is like this distant cousin we know some stuff about, but we never see. I do, however, believe that understanding the components of a scientific experiment is an important layer in understanding the more applied content that you need to know for your exam. But what I want to do today is give you a few shortcuts to help you on exam day. And what this should do is help you eliminate some answer options, but also, more importantly, give you a head start on understanding the basics behind each design. I do ask, please, that you make sure that you spend the needed time to really get more well-rounded in understanding experimental designs, but the exam is just a minimum requirement, so you don't have to be an exam expert. However, reading about it and exploring it like you plan to be can only be a positive experience. Plus, it's always fun to look at the outcomes of some of the amazing technologies of our field. And the only way that you can really get an appreciation for the efficacy of what we do is by looking at all of these, empirically based evidences, which are through experimental design. Anyway, the study hints. Multiple baseline designs. So what you want to remember about each of the designs as I go through them right now is the shortcut study tips thing is the amount of IVs versus DVs, independent variables versus dependent variables. That should help go through some of the questions at minimum, okay? So multiple baseline design, one independent variable and two or more dependent variables. This design examines how one independent variable generalizes its effects across two or more behaviors, settings, subjects. So this is sort of the generalization design shortcut. Changing criterion design has one independent variable and one dependent variable. This design examines how the criteria for reinforcement can control responding. So if behavior is meeting the criteria, then that proves that the criteria is in fact controlling the behavior. Reversal design. One independent variable, one dependent variable. This is the design with the strongest establishment of proof or control. It literally looks at how behavior does with the independent variable versus without it. And the withdrawal design does essentially the same thing in terms of the IVs and the DVs. The multiple treatment reversal. Now, this is a variation of the reversal design. So it also looks to establish proof or control, but this design looks at how the behavior does with multiple independent variables and how those effects are in comparison. So this one has two or more independent variables and one dependent variable. And finally, the alternating treatment or multi-element design, or honestly, a lot of other AKAs that this design has. This design has a minimum of two independent variables and a maximum of four. And there's only one dependent variable. This design looks at how the different independent variables affect the behavior. But unlike the multiple treatment reversal design, this design doesn't exhibit that control in the same proof way because we don't remove the IVs but implement them all at once to see the effects. This is a good design for quickly figuring out which independent variable to use, but also this is the design that we use in functional analysis, except that the IVs are the conditions rather than the treatments when we talk about using this design in the functional analysis. Anyway, this is just a very superficial shortcut, so I do hope it helps, but do study up more and make sure you're super fluent in the designs. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you next time.